So the trade war saga continues to cause concerns. As midweek, we saw the Trump administration propose an additional round of 10% tariffs on $200 billion worth of Chinese goods. China warned it would be forced to respond, sparking fears an escalating trade war between the world's two biggest economies could hit global growth and damage sentiment. Further developments on the subject could also overshadow important macroeconomic data and corporate results throughout the week, which would normally dictate market direction. Donald Trump continues his global tour, having already paid visits to Europe, now goes to Russia in the highly anticipated meeting with President Vladimir Putin. Trump has recently stated that he is not sure whether Putin is a friend or a foe, but they certainly have plenty to talk about, with sanctions, Syria and allegations of Russian meddling in US geopolitical events all on the agenda. First up, data-wise, we get the Chinese GDP, key for metal prices. However, this will not yet have factored in recent tariffs imposed by the US. Critical inflation data from the UK and Eurozone will be monitored closely on Wednesday. This has been a key gauge for both monetary policy stimulus for both central banks. The Bank of England is expected to raise rates by 0.25% to 0.75% next month, for only the second time in over a decade, following strong recent UK data. UK results are gathering momentum. The main UK sector in focus this week will be the mining sector. Trading statements from Rio Tinto and BHP Billiton could dictate the whole sector, which has a large weighting on the FTSE 100 and can be influential for the reasons in the moves that we've seen recently. The important thing to remember is that the US-China trade war could yield results redundant, having such a bearing on the sector. Throughout the week, we also see updates from Royal Mail, EasyJet, Severn Trent, Unilever and SSC. US results continue to come thick and fast. We continue to hear from some of the world's biggest and most influential financial companies, such as Bank of America, BlackRock, Goldman Sachs and Bank of New York. Results from other sectors include the largest aluminium miner in the world, Alcoa, tech behemoth Microsoft, and also everyone's favourite streaming service, Netflix. That's the week ahead. For more information on company results and for economic data, check the email that we will send you. Thank you.